I gotta tell you, I'm pretty happy tonight. 12 months ago, I wasn't so happy. See, last year at this time, I was sitting in a wheelchair, getting ready to go to Detroit, to Ford Field, to sit behind that stage and watch 80,000 WWE fans go absolutely crazy at WrestleMania. I had to sit back and watch the game from the sidelines. Well, after last night, after the Elimination Chamber, after beating five other guys, I can tell you this, the game is back! Back where I belong, back in the main event at the granddaddy of them all, at WrestleMania. And you can bet your ass, when I get there, I am gonna become a 12-time WWE champion. Because at WrestleMania, the king.
We've really come. We've really come all the way around full circle, haven't we, Triple H? Last night it was John Cena. Before him, Jeff Hardy, Chris Jericho, Shawn Michaels. Before all of them, it started with you, Triple H, the man that I beat for the WWE title. We have known each other for a long time. And in that amount of time, a lot of things have changed. But your jealousy for me has always remained the same. 4 years ago, when I became the World Heavyweight Champion, you were jealous of me then, and you're even more jealous of me now because I am that much better. And it makes me happy to hear you out here proclaiming your victory at WrestleMania already, because it makes you, just like all the rest, Triple H. And I have beaten all of the rest. So if you want to have your moment.
Had the best of me, that's why.
1 second. Wait. One cotton picking minute. Yeah. Oh. Yeah, I just went there. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you WWE Champion Randy Orton. A very, very unique individual because he is the first WWE champion to be both a liar and a loser. With all the corruption in sports nowadays, baseball, basketball, football, only fitting that finally disgrace comes to the WWE title. Randy Orton, WWE champion with an asterisk. The only champion to lose his way into WrestleMania. Wait. I got an idea. How about tonight? We have a rematch. Yes, yes, yes. Let's not take the WWE Championship tonight for the WWE Championship. Randy Orton, a.k.a. Captain Donuts, versus John Cena. The winner of that match will be the WWE Champion and face you, Triple H, at WrestleMania.
Are you gonna let him come out here and interrupt what we got going on at WrestleMania? It should be you and me at WrestleMania. It should have nothing to do with John Cena.
I don't know, Randy. Quite honestly, I don't give a crap which one he is champion. When it comes time to WrestleMania, all I know is I got the shot. I'm facing the champ, and I'm gonna beat whoever it is.
Gentlemen, as general manager, I'm going to try and resolve this dispute as fairly as possible. Triple H did win the Elimination Chamber, and so you will definitely be going to the main event at WrestleMania. That's a lock. Randy Orton, you intentionally got yourself disqualified against John Cena last night by hitting a referee in the face. That may be all well and good for you, but it doesn't reflect very well on the Raw brand, and it doesn't reflect well on me. So tonight, seeing as though John Cena won last night, it will be a rematch, but a non-title match. John Cena versus Randy Orton. With the winner, if it is John Cena, going to the main event at WrestleMania in a triple threat match. It will be.
Oh, hold on a second now.
No, you hold on. It will be if John Cena wins. John Cena versus Triple H versus Randy Orton for the WWE title.
That don't work for me, Regal. I won my shot last night. One-on-one against the champ. That's how it goes.
I know this doesn't work for you, but this is where it gets interesting. Because tonight, in the main event match between John Cena and Randy Orton, the one that will decide the main event at WrestleMania, we will have a special guest referee. And it will be the game, Triple H. What?
That's what I'm saying. But it's not gonna matter anyways. Honestly, it doesn't really make a difference to me, you know what I mean? But, hey, hold on a sec. You know what? Let me call you right back. Look, Hunter, our match at WrestleMania can't be a triple threat match. John Cena can't win tonight. He doesn't deserve it. After all, we don't want what happened 2 years ago, WrestleMania, to happen again, do we? You know, when John Cena made you tap out, when he embarrassed you on the biggest stage of all, we don't want that to happen. Come on, it needs to be you and I at WrestleMania. Forget John Cena. Huh? I know you'll call it the right way, right? You with me?
Randy, you trying to play mind games with me? Huh? You trying to swerve me, make me see things your way? Who taught you how to do that, huh? Who's the guy that taught you how to play those mind games? You ain't put nothing over on me. I'm gonna call it the way I see it, Randy. And if it favors anyone, it'll favor me. See you out there, champ.
Game just just laid the law down to Cena. Cena better stay focused on Orton. Uh-oh. Oh.
This is not good.
Oh. Hey! Look at this! Oh, Orton tried the cheap shot. Got that view. And John Cena wins! And John Cena!
Here is your winner, John Cena!
Oh, hey, hey! Wait a minute! Triple H out! Pedigree! John Cena emphatically making a physical statement on the man who has just qualified to be the main event of WrestleMania.
WWE Champion, Randy Orton. And John Cena. At WrestleMania 24, these three men will compete in a historic triple threat main event match for the WWE Championship. In response to various requests that I've been getting, I've arranged for this photo opportunity, so that we can get all three main event competitors captured for prosperity before the big event. So gentlemen, please, your public awaits. Now, I've arranged for you gentlemen all to be given a microphone so we can get your comments regarding what will undoubtedly be one of the most talked about matches in WrestleMania history.
Thanks. And I want to thank the both of you for coming out, because honestly, I got a problem with one of you. The way I was raised, if you got a problem with somebody, if you got something to say, may not be too nice, you ante up, you be a man, and you say it to his face. Half of me has got to thank you. Because last week like that, you could have disqualified me from that match and robbed me of a chance to be in WrestleMania. But I can't much say that I appreciate the pedigree I received as a congratulations. And I got a problem with that.
There's no need to thank me, first of all. I didn't do you any favors. I did what was right. I want you in that ring at WrestleMania. Now, you might not appreciate that pedigree last week, and a lot of these people didn't appreciate that pedigree. No, but a lot of them did. And it doesn't matter to me whether you appreciate it or not. You better get used to it, pal, because at WrestleMania, you're gonna get the same thing.
You know, if my memory serves me correct, I believe there's only been one Clash of the Titans. And when that happened, it was you who tapped out.
Guys, you can talk all the trash that you want. But one thing is going to remain the same. I am still the WWE Champion. Now, both of you have done your best. You've given me your best shot. Yet still I have around my shoulder the WWE title. How's that catchphrase go, John Cena? The champ is here! And there is not a damn thing either of you could do about it.
Here we go.
And now Cena and the Game are getting it on. The two men that will be battling in the main event at WrestleMania. Oh. And again, oh, for RKO. And now, and Orton with a second RKO, a pair of signature RKOs on Randy Orton's two WrestleMania opponents. Message sent, message delivered by the WWE Champion. And is this what we're going to be seeing in the Citrus Bowl at WrestleMania 24.
Oh, hey, just the man I wanted to talk to. Hey, WrestleMania, right around the corner. Money in the Bank. I'm gonna be winning that baby this year. I mean, that's a given. Okay, and like I said I was gonna do last year at WrestleMania 24, I'm gonna be cashing that baby in that night. Now, that means that I'm gonna have to pin whoever is the current WWE champion. So, Randy, I just wanna let you know that if you lose, well, you lose. But if you win, well, you're also gonna lose. Just wanna let you know that, so there's no surprises. Okay?
Ken?
That's Mr. Kennedy.
You can make all of the threats that you want to make to me, but I am still walking out of WrestleMania the WWE Champion.
Okay. We'll see about that.
Let me guess. This is the part where you come in here and you say, you know, Triple H, I don't like you and I know you don't like me, but if we just work together tonight, this'll all be just fine, blah, 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 right? But here's the thing, I don't like you. You don't like me. Matter of fact, if I had it with my way, I wouldn't even be teaming with you tonight. You'd be facing Orton and Kennedy by yourself. But what I do want to do tonight is what I do best, and that's win. I want to show the world what's going to happen at WrestleMania. So do yourself a favor and do me a favor. Try not to get beat.
I didn't come in here to see if you need an extra bottle of water or to say that we don't like each other. Matter of fact, I feel the same way you do. Just came in here to tell you, tonight, you don't need to watch my back. But you certainly need to watch your own.
Mark on Kennedy, who's on Dream Street. Okay, Phil, Cena thinking F you. Orton had other plans, and here comes the game. Cena and Kennedy are the two legal men. Mike Chip. Concerned about it. Kennedy hits and runs, it would seem.
Gentlemen, I've called you here today because I've had a wonderful idea, marvelous idea, how to spice up your Triple Threat Championship match for WrestleMania. I'm going to call it a Triple Threat Takeover. For the next 3 weeks, I won't be in charge. One of you will be. With no repercussions whatsoever, and I'm going to pick somebody, starting tonight, at random, every week, and tonight, it's going to be you, John Cena. So pick the main event and don't take too much time.
This is ridiculous. You want to get hurt 4 weeks before WrestleMania, do you? I know I don't. How about this? How about we make a pact? Whoever's in charge for the next 3 weeks lets the other two have the night off. What do you say? What do you say? You got my word.
Oh, well, Jeff, if we've got your word, I mean, what more could we ask for you? I mean, I trust you the most out of anybody here. What? Why is it again? I trust you. Oh, that's right. I don't trust you. And you know what? I don't trust him either.
Forget trust, pacts, secret handshakes, nights off, whatever. After taking a pedigree 2 weeks ago and an RKO last week, if I put my mind to it, tonight, I can come up with something extremely satisfying.
Yes, John Cena's in charge tonight. No, they didn't like it, no. Should have said the...
Hey, there he is!
Decision.
I thought about it, and I figured why should I put Triple H and Randy Orton in a situation where they have to go through hell and back? The best decision is to just have them go through each other. So tonight, in that very ring, it will be the legend killer Randy Orton versus the game Triple H!
You can't do that. That's just too big. I mean, that's two-thirds of the WrestleMania main event.
Huge, I know. It's awesome.
I suppose you're giving yourself the night off as
well. Yeah, hell no, no. I've had enough nights off to last me a lifetime. Thank you very much. I have some business to attend to with Mr. Kennedy. Kennedy! Thanks. And, if memory serves me correct, it is triple threat takeover night.
Yes.
Brilliant idea. You put me in charge. Awesome, thanks. So this is my office, right? And you can go. Now.
Yeah, nice.
Yeah, you can go. And scene. This is where you go. This is my place now. Good game.
I've got something to do.
Yeah, you do. All right. Cheerio, lad. God save the queen. Oh, yeah.
Cena's clotheslines will do that to anybody. And John Cena coming right back with raw, unmitigated power. Wait a minute. Cena going up top.
Up top is right.
Incoming. Whoa! Oh, what a leg drop from the top. The STF, a submission maneuver.
STF, you locked in.
There it is. He's got it.
Your time is up. My time is now.
Here is your winner by submission, John Cena.
Well, the STFU lead John Cena to the WWE title in that triple threat showdown against Triple H and Randy Orton at WrestleMania.
Cena keeping his eyes on the prize.
And you gotta wonder what kind of condition Orton in. John, you've been in that situation before. Triple threat matches, you lose the championship.
You really just gotta keep your head on a swivel. There is nothing worse than not being beaten by pinfall or submission and losing a match.
Now, how much are you gonna enjoy this match that you put together here tonight?
Well, I think for the fans here at Conseco Fieldhouse, they are packed to the rafters, and this is a fantastic main event. From a personal standpoint, I get a little bit of leeway and a jump start on my opponents for WrestleMania 24.
Certainly, you know both these men very well. Everybody always tries to add a little something extra as you roll into WrestleMania. Paul, play one card you haven't played. Maybe you'll get that indicator here tonight in this fabulous main event that John Cena, here with us live at ringside, has made.
Everybody steps it up on the way to the dance, JR. Everybody steps it up on the way to WrestleMania. That's talent, that's fans alike. This place is packed. These guys are dead serious.
Look at
that stare right there.
In the eyes.
A lot of intensity, obviously, between these two men who have a tremendous rivalry.
Like you said, Orton, with that viper-like mind, can strike at any moment, and an RKO is an immediate three-second knockout.
Collar and elbow tie-up with Orton with the advantage, forcing the game back in the corner. Will we get a clean break, or need I ask? Triple H reversing.
Back it up, Triple H. Back it off. Bill.
Ah. Maybe Randy for once getting a little taste of his own medicine.
Shot headlock takeover.
And like I said before, Triple H, so calculated yet so strong. He has the respect, he has the strength, he has the experience, he has the mind, he is the total package.
And you talked about that RKO being a 3-second knockout. What about the pedigree?
That is for sure. Lights out, game over.
Orton tried the head scissors, it was countered. Back to the side headlock. And Orton again with a counter. As these two men have been there before, and they have, and a thunderous right hand that found its mark.
Randy Orton wants to trade blows with Triple H.
Big time right hand. Well, earlier, John J.R. and I talked among ourselves before you came out here. And we were hesitant to mention the fact that, well, what Randy Orton did to your dad. You brought it up. So, I mean,
gosh, here's a cover, a cover, a hook of the leg, and a near fall. My gosh, what impact from a clothesline.
Back to what Randy Orton did to your dad. Is that going to be extra incentive? At WrestleMania, will you be targeting Orton more than the game?
KJR, you know that WrestleMania is the stage where it needs to happen. If I need that extra
cover,
motivation,
another cover here.
I won't forget that Randy Orton not only disabled my father, but disabled me. You have to understand that Randy Orton does anything he needs to do to win. I said, I'm not going to invite him to my Christmas party, but he gets the job done. There'll be no love lost on WrestleMania 12.
Well, he got the job done there. Dumped Triple H right out of the ring.
Orton thinking right there. And creating some distance and now getting in the face of the game. Retaliating with big time right hands on the outside. Senior referee Mike Kyoto's got a 10 count to work with. Whoa. Just got introduced to the WWE champion, or perhaps it's the other way around. Big right hands, a physical match, an intense matchup. And the game, oh, look out.
Oh, man.
That inverted backbreaker by Orton.
I don't know necessarily if they got all that one, but I know it's enough to slow him down.
We remember just a couple of months ago when Randy Orton became the WWE champion. He became the WWE champion after the game won the title, then had to defend the title against Umaga, and here's a cover, and Triple H kicks out. And then in a third match, it was Randy Orton and Triple H's third championship match in one night where Orton won the matchup. Triple H certainly hasn't forgotten it, and I haven't forgotten what a match that was.
It's like I said, Randy Orton doesn't necessarily care how he got there. The self-proclaimed one-man dynasty cares about one thing, holding on to the WWE Championship by any means necessary.
And John, that all came about after Orton hurt you.
Yes.
And you had to surrender the championship.
Yes, and I don't want to say he had the fast track to the WWE Championship. You can't take anything away from Randy Orton, but he certainly did have a set of circumstances that did work in his favor.
Well, speaking of hurting, both Randy Orton and Triple H, putting a hurt on each other in this match.
Yeah, what a vicious knee. What a vicious knee. Let me do it. And Orton got another cover. What a knee right to the sternum.
John, what you got to remember is in the next couple of weeks, these two guys are going to have, they're going to take over in this triple threat takeover. What do you think? They're going to have in store for you.
Well, one can only tell. That's why anything can happen on any given Monday, King.
And here we go to the cover. The knee drop to the back. And the lateral press again, Randy Orton dominating the action at this particular point in time.
Randy is his best when he gets that slight advantage. You crack open a little bit, you make that one mistake. Like you said, JR, he's like a fighter. He strikes with precision and he will take you down.
Orton can be very, can show no remorse. Remorseless individual, to say the least. But the game showing the resiliency of an 11-time champion comes back fighting against the current WWE champion.
Huge right hand from the game. Look out here.
Oh, baby.
Face buster action.
Orton set himself a second too soon.
You want to talk about openings and changes in momentum.
That high knee caught Orton, who luckily for him was able to roll to the outside. Man, what a man of men here tonight. On the road to WrestleMania. And it is a rocky road right now for Randy Orton. And as the old cliche, Triple H is dancing with what brung him. That big right hand, really effective here tonight. And a spine buster, big time, high impact spine buster. Orton in trouble. Orton senses it. Orton again rolling out of bounds, if you will. Orton trying to distance himself from Triple H.
Wait a minute, what is Orton doing here?
Orton's match is not over. Orton got his WWE Championship.
No, this match isn't over. Not this match.
Wait. John Cena.
As if the WWE champion Randy Orton was going to take his belt and go home, John Cena intervened, and the cerebral assassin capitalizing on the entire situation.
Watch it. Orton.
Oh! Orton looking for a cheap shot. And Cena in.
Look at this!
Cena in. RKO! My God! What an RKO! Cena and Triple H are down, and Randy Orton dodged a huge bullet and has capitalized on Triple H and Cena's physicality. And man, can you just imagine?
And that's what Orton's going to have to do at WrestleMania. Capitalize on any given situation.
But what's going to happen next Monday night when Triple H or Randy Orton are running the show?
Touching moment. And I wish I could just leave it at that, but you see, I can't, unfortunately, because tonight is not only WrestleMania Rewind, it's also part two of the Triple Threat Takeover. Last week, Regal put John Cena in charge. This week, it is my turn. So two things. First, Triple H will face in a WrestleMania rematch one of his good old friends, Kane. And second, well, Sean, that's why I'm out here. You've done many things at WrestleMania, many things, but last year's WrestleMania, you didn't do something. You didn't win. And I'm gonna give you your chance to redeem yourself tonight. Ric Flair, pay attention, because Shawn Michaels can be beat. Just ask his opponent, John Cena.
Let me just start out by saying, I live to be WWE Champion. Last year at WrestleMania, it was supposed to be the rematch of the century for the WWE Championship, Cena, Triple H. It never happened. I sat on the sidelines and watched WrestleMania pass me by with an injury. When I returned, Cena was gone, and I became the 11-time WWE Champion, a reign that was put to an end by Randy Orton. The rematch between me and Orton never happened. So now in 3 weeks at WrestleMania, I get the opportunity to take back what is mine. I get the opportunity to end something that has been burning a hole in me for 2 years. At WrestleMania, I will fight for the WWE Championship like my life depends on it. Because as far as I'm concerned, it does. Cena, Orton, game on.
Listen, I know what you're thinking. You're thinking how much you hate Triple H. And trust me, I hate him too. That's why I chose you. I could have chose anybody, but I chose you. I've done my history, Kane. Triple H has handed you all sorts of losses, embarrassed you time and time again. Hell, he even unmasked you on television. Pretty much over the years, Triple H has made you his... When it comes to Triple H, I don't need a history lesson, Randy. I remember everything.
Distracted the game.
Well, it looked like Randy Orton was on his way down here to the ring, but
Orton pacing like a caged animal. And now Kane. Oh, Kane took a chance that didn't pay off. Oh, quickly the game counter. The cerebral assassin counters quickly with a pedigree. Orton didn't like what he's seen. The game said the hole had been burning in him for 2 years to regain the WWE title in headline WrestleMania.
Boy, and look at this. The eyes of the game are riveted on one thing. It's that championship that's on the shoulder of Randy Orton.
Triple H missed last year's WrestleMania in the main event. But the game will damn sure be at this one.
I've often been asked the question, what does WrestleMania mean to me? Everyone's been asked that question, every fan, every superstar, and the answer is somewhat cliche, it means everything. This year, I can put it into perspective for all of you. I wasn't supposed to be back in action till October. I suffered an injury that was supposed to keep me sidelined for a year. And in January, I took a chance. I risked my health, I risked my career, I risked all the success that I've accrued in this business for one chance. One chance to possibly walk down that aisle and be on that stage. I've heard the experts, the critics, I should be angry at Randy Orton for my torn pec. I thank Randy Orton, because maybe in the back of my head I was a little bit complacent. And then it was taken away. My dream, my livelihood was taken away from me. And I know what that felt like. I never want to feel that again. It made me fight, it made me hungry, it made me want to come back for WrestleMania. It made me want to be in the show, in the biggest match of them all, against the WWE champion Randy Orton, a man who I respect for his accomplishments in this business, Triple H and myself. Simply put, WrestleMania is the top dogs fighting it out for the biggest prize in sports entertainment. And I know what it's like to get your hand raised on that day. And at WrestleMania, rest assured my time will come again.
You want to know why I'm the perfect champion? Because you can take the strength of John Cena, the intelligence of Triple H, the desire of Cena, the athleticism of Triple H, the determination of Cena, the ruthlessness of Triple H, and if you combine these attributes into one person, you get Randy Orton. The only difference is I have one thing that neither Cena nor Triple H has. The WWE Championship.
Something's got to give here. How's this one? Right hands.
A battle. And bodies literally holding each other up. Oh, not for long. Oh,
wait a minute.
What? What in the world?
Randy Orton, the WWE Champion, after Cena hit the ring post.
Watch out.
Wait a minute. Come on. Orton wanted Cena to be softened up by Shawn Michaels, and now it looks like Orton's going to do it himself.
Well, you're right. It looks like Orton thought that Shawn Michaels would do the damage, but he's not content with that. Orton's going to do it himself. Oh, come on, ref.
Cena's in a helpless state here.
Oh, no.
Here it comes. The RKO. Cena able to somehow, someway counter. Now Cena with the
MU. Cena dropped Randy Orton right across that middle chair and then delivered a picture perfect MU.
John Cena somehow battled through Shawn Michaels.
You have to admit, it's been a very entertaining last couple of weeks. Last week with John Cena in charge, this week with Randy Orton in charge. Well, next week, it's my turn. And oh, have I got a show for you. In that very ring next week, it's gonna be John Cena and Randy Orton. You might say to yourself, oh my God, Triple H, Cena and Orton against each other, one-on-one? Oh no. They're not opponents. They're tag team partners. That's right. Cena and Orton in the ring fighting for the common good, watching each other's backs. You might ask yourself then, who will their opponents be? That's where it gets interesting. Cena and Orton will be partnered against the entire Raw roster.
Did we hear that right? The entire Raw roster?
Triple H.
Yes.
Marvelous idea for the main event tonight, but you just missed it. Brian Kendrick just walked out on Paul London, and I was thinking if I was John Cena or Randy Orton, I'd be doing the exact same thing.
Oh, but they can't.
Why?
Well, you see, Orton and Cena are teaming up tonight to face the entire Raw roster, but neither one can leave the other.
Yeah, but there's no way that you can ensure that.
Oh, sure there is. It's pretty simple, actually. You see, if Cena leaves Orton, then Cena's out of the match at WrestleMania. If Orton leaves Cena, well, then I strip Randy Orton of the WWE Championship and Cena and I fight over it at WrestleMania. It's pretty standard stuff, really.
But you can't do that because I'm in charge.
Quite the contrary. Triple threat takeover. Remember saying that? I'm in charge this week. And if you got a problem with that, it's too bad. You made the rules. I'm just following them.
Well, if you're going to do that, why don't you just strip Randy Orton of the title and take it for yourself tonight?
There's a couple reasons for that. One is, doing this is actually a lot more fun. The other reason, I've had titles awarded to me in the past. There's no satisfaction in it. But don't worry, I'll be getting the WWE Championship soon enough. But it won't be handed to me I'll be taking it on the grandest stage of them all at WrestleMania.
Well, now that you're in the right frame of mind, there's nothing left to say. We go out there, we beat everybody until there's nobody left to beat on Raw. See you out there.
John, listen. I think it's pretty obvious. Triple H is doing this to see us get hurt before WrestleMania.
Probably right.
I know I'm right. So this is what I suggest. We turn the tables, take a dive, we lay down, and so what? We lose. Big deal. None of us gets hurt before WrestleMania. What do you think?
You always got a plan. Huh. I like it. You want to go out there and lose on purpose? Go ahead and lose. Look.
John, I'm the WWE champion. So, I figured if anyone's gonna lay down, it's gonna be you.
Now, Randy, I'm probably not as smart as you are. But I'm certainly not a friggin' coward. I'm not going out and losing on purpose.
Maybe you didn't hear me. I said I'm the WWE champion. And I think that you should do what I say.
No, I heard you. And the day that I listen to someone who's responsible for my torn pec, stealing my title, and punt-kicking my father in the face is the day I lose my mind. You want to go out there and lose on purpose, and go ahead. You want to go out there and turn your back on me, go ahead. Triple H will not stop until both of us have been beaten within an inch of our lives. So, one of two things. You stay here and try to figure it out, or you go out there. You ante up and you fight like a man.
Randy, that's the only chance we got.
Actually, you don't have any chance at all. See, because the rules of this match are very simple. It's you two against the entire roster, and the match will continue until you have beaten every single one of your opponents, or until you can no longer physically continue. But between us, I just want you guys to know, I'm rooting for you.
Uh-oh! You can't see me! Little five-knuckle shuffle action coming from Cena!
Cena drilling the rookie from Calgary. The FU, the cover, and Cena's rolling and makes the tag to Orton. Cody Rhodes back in. And the rookie, the teamwork.
Unbelievable.
The teamwork, good Lord. Self-preservation for Orton and for Cena.
Wait a minute.
And now hell is breaking loose.
Well, I think a Raw roster saw themselves being decimated. What's happened here?
Referee called for the bell. The referee's called for the bell, and this is nothing but chaos as Cena and Orton being beat down by several members of the Raw roster, and the match is going to continue until Cena and Orton can't physically compete.
Wait a minute. Cena's got a steel chair.
Oh!
Good grief!
Cena going downtown with a steel chair. Oh my! Right to the throat of John Cena. And now you've got Umaga and JBL with a weapon.
Oh, this is bad. But this is exactly what the Blades was hoping for, in my opinion. Look.
God, JBL misfired, and the Samoan Savage, what a spike right in the pavement over the champion.
Umaga's after JBL.
JBL running from Umaga, but Umaga delivered the spike to Randy Orton. There's no one left for the Rock. ladies and gentlemen, I stand corrected. There is someone left on the Raw roster.
It's all about the game, and how you play it. It's all about control, and if you can take it.
The maestro of tonight's amazing main event, the game, on the last night of the Triple Threat Takeover, orchestrated the most amazing main event. A main event that will continue till John Cena and the WWE Champion could neither physically continue. And we're talking 13 days from WrestleMania until these three men compete for the most coveted championship in all the WWE.
After weeks of FUs, RKOs, pedigrees, threats, promises, guarantees, double crosses, death stares, mind games, takeovers, torn pecs, torn quads, a king of kings who kills legends that you can't see. And whatever the hell else you want to throw into that cornucopia of WrestleTainment, Sunday, we dance! Let me remind each and every one of you, this is a business about what you have done for me, not what have you done for me lately. Ladies and gentlemen, this Sunday is WrestleMania! And after last week having waged war with 17 other men, I can stand here and say that I'm looking pretty good to walk into Orlando, the number one contender, and leave as the WWE Champion! Some of you that agree with that.
Well, it's the beast.
You understand that, don't you, Cena?
Actually, I wasn't listening to anything you said. I was just remembering how I beat your ass at WrestleMania 21. Man, those were good times. What were you saying?
Here's what everyone needs to remember about WrestleMania. Some people think that the Big Show is going to knock out Mayweather. Some people think that JBL is going to beat up Finley. And some people think that either you, John Cena, or Triple H is going to walk out as champion. But nobody thinks that I am going to retain, which is the way that I like it, because I feed off of that. And it means to me, I'm going to be the one that everyone is talking about. After I win the triple threat, retain my title at WrestleMania.
Ah! Lei não precisa falhar! Lei precisa ocorrer! Batista! Pelo aí, como vai parar? São papo! Biggie!
Wayne, it just so happens that I'm fluent in Samoan. And Umaga's right. Randy Orton, here's a weird man who listens to boy bands, loves sperm whales, and watches reruns of My Two Dads all the time. And Umaga, I thank you for your support. I am going to make sure there is no way that this man keeps the WWE Championship.
I know what you're thinking, first of all, and you're absolutely right. This is the brand new Triple H t-shirt. And you're right, it's awesome, I know. Now listen, you all make convincing arguments about your place in WrestleMania and in history, and I'm not gonna say that you're not gonna go out there and have the great match that you say you're gonna have. I'm not gonna say you're not gonna go out there and knock out Floyd Mayweather. I'm not. Anyway, what I am gonna say is this. There is one reason, and all of you know it, one reason why we are all in this business. There is one reason why we get out of bed every day and lay our bodies on the line. And it is that WWE Championship sitting on your shoulder. You guys would all change your spots in a heartbeat for a shot at that. Now there's one reason why this WrestleMania is being held in Orlando at the Citrus Bowl in a building with no roof on it. Because when Randy Orton, John Cena, and Triple H, the three biggest stars in this business, get in that ring for a triple threat match for the WWE Championship, if there was a roof, we would damn well blow it off. Now, that being said, at WrestleMania, say this clearly so you can hear me. At WrestleMania, the King of Kings goes back on his throne. And there ain't a damn thing you can do about it.
I don't give a damn about your throne. I don't give a damn.
Well, nobody gives a damn about you.
Hey, you want to get this off right here?
You can do it whenever you want.
I'll fight you.
It don't matter what you say.
Stop talking. Listen to me. Now, you all have a legitimate claim to being the standout attraction at WrestleMania. And tonight, I'm going to give you each the chance to prove it. Because tonight's main event is going to be a WrestleMania showcase. We're going to have an 8-man no disqualification match. On one side will be Randy Orton, Umanga, JBL, and The Big Show. And they will be facing John Cena, Triple H, Shawn Michaels, and the Nature Boy, Ric Flair.
Hey, defense, and then the ref goes, corn dog, Daggy, corn dog.
Save it for WrestleMania, guys.
Come on, guys.
There's gonna be no fight, Val. Don't worry about it. Just want you to know something. I want to be perfectly clear about this Sunday. See, 2 years ago, you beat me at WrestleMania. And it's been burning a hole in me ever since. You know why? Because I know that I didn't get beat by the better man. I know that I'm better than you. I might have lost, but I'm the better man. Now, injuries happen. We all go our separate ways. But the fact is, when I came back, the Royal Rumble was my shot. You were standing in my way. I go to the Elimination Chamber and beat, what, 5 other guys? Get my shot at the WWE Championship, and you, again, are standing in my way. I'm just letting you know, this Sunday, you get my way, and I am gonna mow you down.
You lose a match, and it burns a hole inside you. Is that a fact? Try watching for 6 months while a man carries around a championship that you never lost. Sunday you want to find me, I will be standing in your way. Because at WrestleMania, the WWE Championship comes home.
Of the WWE Champion. Oh my goodness.
Wait a minute! Oh, that's your partner!
Man, that is an evil, powerful weapon, that choke slam from the biggest athlete in the world.
And especially when it's delivered on you by somebody you think's your partner. Now what?
Randy Orton is the legal man in the ring here.
Wait a minute, thank you.
And the odds are... Uh-oh, look! That's TFU!
Oh!
And the game taking exception to John Cena.
Wait a minute, these guys are on the same team as well, but...
Emotions are overflowing between Cena and Triple H. Sunday, Shawn Michaels, Manly Flair with a big right hand.
And these guys are on the same team, Flair and Michaels.
The dirtiest player in the game responds. And now it's down to Flair and Orton.
Look at this.